Hello everyone! Today's video is a little bit unusual because I will not show you cool skateboarding models or painting techniques. I will be working with rather some unusual chemicals because I will show you how to make handmade photo etch parts. I will need several small plastic containers, such as this. Perhaps. UV lamp. A transparent plastic sheet. A zinc sheet. This is for photo etch parts. Duct tape. Photosensitive lacquer. Some water. And of course, several different chemicals, such as sodium hydroxide, ferric chloride, hydrogen peroxide, or hydrogen chloride. And of course, don't forget protective equipment, such as goggles and rubber gloves.
Of course, you can use gas mask. It's very cool.
At times, I really felt just like a kid with a little chemic set, or rather, like Walter White from Breaking Bad series. So let's see how to make your own photo etch parts.
For the etching process, I usually use a zinc sheet with a thickness of 0.1 or 0.2 mm. I use one with a thickness of 0.1 mm during this video. First, I drew negative image in GIMP, which is graphical editor program. Then, I ordered one to be printed in professional quality on transparent plastic sheet in our local printing company. Everything black is not going to be etched. I measure and cut the desired piece of the zinc sheet. I want to etch the sheet only from one side, so I put a duct tape on the other one. It's a quite an easy way how to protect it against etching. It is important to smooth out bubbles on the duct tape. I continue with surface finishing. It must be cleaned with sandpaper and degreased with alcohol, so the photosensitive coating adheres to it much better. A very important step in the procedure is to apply a photosensitive coating. I use positive 20 spray can, which is a photosensitive positive resist lacquer. I make a very thin layer, which spreads out over the surface and forms a continuous layer. It is necessary to let it dry for about 24 hours in the dark room or closet, since the light couldn't damage it. It is finally dry, so I can continue. I put the foil with a negative image on the lacquer side and wipe it down with a glass plate, so that the foil is touching the entire surface of the zinc sheet. Now I light the sheet up with a UV lamp for 60 seconds. And now comes the critical phase, chemical development. I prepare two plastic containers. One of them contains sodium hydroxide, which acts as a developing agent, and the second contains clean water, which serves as a neutralizing agent. Do not leave the zinc sheet in the developer for too long, because it could wash away the lacquer from the places which we want to preserve. Then I gently wash away excess lacquer with a fine brush, while it is still submerged in the developing agent. Afterwards, I fastly move it into the container with the clean water to neutralize the chemical reaction. And this is the result which I want to achieve. It looks really nice. As you can see, the green paint remains only on the not eliminated places. The developing agent can be used repeatedly, therefore I pour it back into the another plastic bottle. And now it's finally time to show you what you are waiting for. Etching is actually the easiest part of the whole procedure. I pour ferric chloride into the plastic container, and then I simply drop the zinc sheet with a lacquer side at the bottom into the agent. It's highly recommended to use a protective equipment, like goggles and rubber gloves. Ferric chloride is not a strong acid and it can be washed away if it comes in contact with your skin, but it's always better to be cautious. If the acid is new, then it etches the metal sheet in 2 hours. Its efficiency is decreased after repeated usage. This is how the zinc sheet looks like after 1 hour in the solution. After 2 hours it's finished. I pull the zinc sheet out of the solution and then I neutralize it in the water. It is easy to clean the photosensitive coating with alcohol. At the end, I just take off the covering duct tape and we are done. You just need to paint the new part and place it into the diorama. It isn't beautiful. So I showed you how to etch in ferric chloride. But it wouldn't be me if I didn't try another chemicals too. The much faster process is etching in the solution of hydrogen peroxide and hydrogen chloride. However, it's very important to use protective equipment, and it's also the best to do it outdoors, since the solution is very smelly. The mixture is quite simple. One part of water and one part of hydrogen peroxide and one part of hydrogen chloride. I use exactly the same zinc sheet coated in photosensitive lacquer and then developed in the sodium hydroxide. I dip into the solution using plastic clamp or forceps. Everything made of the metal would corrode. The whole process takes less than 2 minutes. I neutralize the metal sheet in the water. And so we have finished, and this video tutorial is almost finished too. I would like to summarize it at the end. Although the etching with hydrogen chloride is faster, it is harder to keep the etching process under control, and it is also much more dangerous. And of course, it's very smelly. Therefore, I rather recommend the first option when you etch in the solution of ferric chloride. It is not a problem to do it at home, and you do not have to supervise the etching process. You can simply put the parts into the solution and pull them out after a few hours. So that is really all. Here are some examples of etched parts. Thanks for watching, and do not forget to subscribe to my channel. See you next time!